Hello. In this video, we're going to be working on writing Python bindings to the Go implementation of IPFS. So we have a lot of both data and models that need to be stored and moved around. This is the training data, and looking to write some automation to help deal with all of this, and part of that is using IPFS. So the specific thing I want to do is write a script to automate adding IPFS links to all of the data. So there are already IPFS links for the models. As you can see here, but I just did all of these manually. So I'd like to write a script that can take in the index of all of the training data, download each link over HTTP, and then add it to IPFS. So there is the start of a Python implementation for IPFS. And I was asking them about that. It sounds like it's a ways to go. So I think a better strategy is going to be binding to the main implementation, which is in Go at the OS level. So, just a background on IPFS, it's a peer-to-peer file distribution system, and it uses something called a distributed hash table, where you have given the given an IPFS link, which looks like this, you have a hash of the root of this file or directory, and then you're able to find other people who also have or are looking through or are looking for this hash, and distribute the files between yourselves peer-to-peer. So it means just based on this hash, you're able to find other people with the file. My understanding is it also essentially works as a file system. So you have something analogous to like an inode, which are essentially blocks that represent data or directories or whatever, and then they have more blocks that can point to other like subfiles and directories. So I think with IPFS you could essentially post a link for the top of a directory, and then every file and even part of a file within that directory would have its own hash with the distributed hash table. So if one person was distributing a large directory and one person just wanted a single file in it, they would still be able to collaborate and share those files peer-to-peer. But back to what we're actually working on. So I think we just want to install it through the package manager. right? So when I do it manually, I do IPFS add and then the path. So we should get an example one. Let's do. Okay. Okay. So, when I do it manually, I just do IPFS add data. Beautiful. Okay, so I do IPFS add, and then it hashes the file, and you get the, and then the IPFS link would be IPFS, like that. And then, so this by default, we're not actually hosting the files, which IPFS calls pinning. The ones for the models, there's someone from Reddit that I think is pinning them for us for now. But as long as we also have the HTTP links available, people can always get access to the file and start pinning them if they'd like to. So we need to get, so the issue with IPFS add is it, we need to get a command that's just this to be able to use it. Be quiet or quieter. Okay. So this is quiet. Oh, perfect. Looks quieter. Okay, let's go with quieter. Okay. We don't want to do subprocess. Oh, maybe we should. Okay. I think we want this capture output. Capture output. Next. Okay. All right. Nice. All right. All right, it's probably a good place to stop for now.